During the 1960s, Charleston was a different place than we know today. Separation was unknown. But was it equal? Was it right? A young lady by the name of Dr. Melissa Brown, who was born here in Charleston, South Carolina, believed that she can be a part of change.
My name is Millicent Brown. I am a history professor at Claflin University. I am a native of Charleston, South Carolina. In 1963, I was a part of a group of 11 students who were the first black students to attend all white schools in Charleston. I attended Rivers High School. I went into the 10th grade and I was 15 years old at the time. It wasn't my steps. It was really the steps of my parents and lots of other adults who for a very long time had been trying to get rid of segregated schools. And so for many, many, many years, people had been arguing that this was wrong. You should not segregate people by race. So when the Supreme Court in 1954 ruled that once and for all, there should be no separate schools in the United States, my parents started trying to get my sister to be able to leave the all-black school and attend the school that that had been all-white. And they did not respond. It didn't work well. They just ignored us for years. My sister graduated from high school, and we thought, oh gosh, now what are we going to do? Well, my father and mother switched my name on the suit, and then the case stayed in my name for a while. And so it was over 9 years before Charleston actually paid attention to the Supreme Court decision of 1954. When I went to school and I encountered people who were not always kind or friendly, I always knew I could go back home to my community. The impact of being one of the first to go into the schools is that after the first came the second, after the second came the third. If somebody doesn't step up and demand that things change, things will never change. I think somebody had to be first, and I just happened to be that person.